Trent Bradshaw, Brandon Rogers with Bradshaw Financial Planning, and thank you for joining us for Mind Your Money. Hey, we're back to give you an update. Market volatility obviously is continuing at this point. Go back to last Wednesday to where we are right now. We've had roughly about an 8% correction. Yes, it's been fast. Yes, it's been swift. But we want to bring some perspective to what's going on right now. I'll add some additional things that we heard from Larry Kudlow earlier today. But Brandon, let's talk about past events and what the market's done in regards to response.
Yeah. So, I mean, again, every situation's different, of course. Obviously, it's got that caveat out there. But when we take a look at some of these, you know, massive panic situations when you have some health scare like this happen, we just want to take a look historically what things have happened and how the market's reacted, right? So, you know, when you take a look, first off, over a 38-day trading period at the height of the SARS virus, that was in 2003, S&P 500 fell about 12.8%. It had since and then recovered after that, okay?
And there's really nothing to expect anything different this time.
Right.
The fear that was around the SARS virus itself and that event is very similar to what we're seeing now.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know how serious this is, and it could go to that extent.
Right. Yeah. I mean, we're obviously getting new information every day, so we'll continue to monitor that. But it still took a period of time for that all day to come in, market to fall, and then see some type of rebound after that. Next one we'll look at a little more recent, the Zika virus. That was between 2015 and into 16. S&P fell 12.9% during that period of time. Market still recovered and hit new highs on that one as well. Okay, so again, later on, you're going to go way back, 1918, the Spanish flu was out and about, and it killed hundreds of thousands of actually Americans from that end. But, you know, it's 2020 now, the technology, the medical community, the news and everything, the precautions we have in place is much different. But I bring that up to still say the market still rebounded from a situation like that. So, you know, this is something that, you know, Trent and I kind of look at just to try to say, hey, don't panic. Don't let emotion really get in the way right now. And, you know, we're basically making sure we're watching over everything.
Right. And if you look at the overall corrections and volatility that's associated with the market, one thing we've learned since the financial crisis back in 2008, when we have a correction or uncertainty with the market, it's fast, it's violent.
Yeah.
And
uncomfortable.
and very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
But ultimately, you've got to put it in perspective of past events similar to what's going on now. And I know everybody says this time it's different. But look at the past events. Know that there can be a correction of 10 to 15% at any given time. But you've also got to have faith in our administration and the Federal Reserve and other divisions of our Congress to make the necessary adjustments we need to come out of this. And in the past, it's always occurred. And the market figures it out and helps correct itself over time.
Yeah.
All right. So we'll keep an eye on it. Again, if we don't get any type of support from the Federal Reserve, again, Larry Kudlow came out earlier today. Doesn't look like the Federal Reserve is going to panic anytime soon and lower interest rates or increase liquidity. That could cause additional volatility because that's what the market's looking for at this point. So just be aware of that. We're looking at the market. We'll make necessary changes at a given point if we need to.
Exactly.
All right. Thank you for joining us for Mind Your Money. Look forward to hearing from you soon. You got any questions or concerns, feel free to give us a call. Trent Bradshaw, Brandon Rogers, Bradshaw Financial Planning. Have a great day.